Hi, welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video, we'll discuss about Boolean logic, what is truth table, and all terminologies involved in this course. So, what is Boolean logic? Boolean logic consists of Boolean variables and logical operators. We'll call either this as Boolean logic or binary logic. This Boolean and binary we will interchangeably use it, because with binary logic we use the values 0 or 1, and with Boolean 0 will stand for false and 1 will stand for true. So we will interchangeably use the Boolean and binary word in this course. And when you consider a Boolean variable, we will represent any Boolean variable using an alphabet as usual, like in any other algebra. And logical operators will include NOT operator, AND operator, and OR operator. These three operators are fundamental binary logic operators. And we can write a Boolean expression like this: Z is equal to X or Y. This plus symbol actually here stands for logical OR. And the Z, X and Y all represents Boolean variable. And this plus stands for the logical OR operator. Next we will see what is logic gates and truth table. A logic gate is an electronic circuit that will get one or more binary input and gives one binary output. That is, it is a small electronic circuit that is going to accept one or more zeros or ones as input and produces a single output, which is also a binary output. And truth table is a relationship that shows the relationship between the input and output. In the truth table, we will list out all possible combinations of input. That is, if you have an expression with n input variables, there will be 2 power n possible input combinations. Why? Because each input is going to take one of the two values, 0 or 1. So that is why we have the base here as 2, and then we have n input variables. So we will have totally 2 power n input combinations. So we will list out all those 2 power n input combinations, and we will write down what is the corresponding output, and truth table will tell you this relationship. So from the truth table you will come to know the functioning of the Boolean expression that you have in hand. Next we will see the binary operators. The first operator is a NOT operator, and this is a unary operator. That means that it is going to operate on a single input. The binary operator NOT is indicated by a prime symbol. This is a prime symbol. Or we will indicate that by a over bar like this. We have A bar. Or we can use a tilde symbol or a negation symbol. And when we use a tilde or a negation, we will say negation A or tilde A to represent the NOT operation. And this is basically the complement operation. So we will write the equation like this: output Y is equal to A complement, or we say A bar is actually A complement. Y is equal to A complement. Since this is a complement operation, the output is going to be the flipped input. So this is the truth table. This is the input. And since there is only one variable, it can either take 0 or it can take 1 as input. If you feed in 0 as input, you will get its flipping, which is 1 as output. And if you feed in 1 as input, you will get 0 as output. And this is the graphical representation of the NOT operator. Usually this triangle represents a buffer and this bubble represents the complement. So wherever you see a bubble in the gate, it is a NOT operation actually. Next is the binary AND operation. Here we represent the operation either with dot operator or a conjunction operator or a cap operator, or we will not specify anything like this. We have two Boolean variables and in between we haven't represented any operation. In that case it is a AND operation, the logical AND operation. We can write the expression, Boolean expression, as y is equal to, the output y is equal to A and B. The gate will give 1 as output if all the input is 1, otherwise it is 0. That is the operation of AND logical operation. That is, A and B are inputs, y is the output. If all the inputs are 1, then the output is 1. Otherwise, it is 0. Okay, if both the inputs are 0 or if any one of the input has 0, then the output is 0. The graphical representation is like this. You have A, B as input and you will produce Y as output. But this input is not limited to only 2 inputs. You can extend this to any number of inputs. In that case also the output will be 1 only if all the inputs are fed 1 as input. Otherwise it is going to produce 0 as output. The next operation is the OR operation. We will represent the OR operation either with a plus symbol or a pipe symbol or a disjunction symbol. It is like a V actually. The Boolean expression we will write like this. The output Y is equal to A or B. And the output will be 1 if we have at least one of the input is 1. That is the operation of OR operator. We can see this in the truth table. A and B are input, Y is the output. If any one of the input or both the inputs are 1, then we will have the output to be 1. Otherwise it is 0. If all the inputs are 0, then we have a 0 as output. Graphically it is represented by a curved line in the input side, and the input need not be limited to only 2 inputs. It can be extended to any number of inputs. In that case also, if any one of the input is 1, the output is going to be 1. Otherwise if all the inputs are 0, then the output is 0. Next is the NAND operation. That is, you perform AND operation and to the result of AND operation you are going to complement the output of AND operation. That is the NAND operation. The truth table shows this relationship. A and B are input, Y is the output. If you feed in 00 as input, the output of AND gate is going to be 0. If you negate that 0, you will get 1 as output. So for any of the input, if at least you have 10 in the input, the output of the AND operation is going to be 0 and the negation of that is going to be the NAND output. So if any one of the input is 0, then you are going to get 1 as output in the NAND operation. If all the inputs are 1, then the output is 0. And graphically it is represented like this. This is AND gate and this bubble is the NOT gate, right? So it is the AND operation is negated. The output of the AND gate is negated and we get the output of the NAND gate. This NAND gate is not a fundamental operation because we have used the fundamental operations which are AND. The fundamental operations are OR, AND and NOT. These three operations are the fundamental logical operations, and this NAND operation is a derivation of the fundamental operations. We are using the AND operation, we are using the complement operation. So this is a derived operation, and this is a very special operation. We will see why later in this session. Next is NOR operation. This is also one of the special operations, and it is also a derived operation. As the name suggests, it is the NOT operation applied to the OR result. That is, you perform the OR operation first and then you negate that result. Okay, that is indicated by this expression as well. You have A or B and then you complement the result of OR to get the output of NOR gate. Symbolically also you see the same thing. You have the OR operator and then the result of the OR is negated. So what is OR operator? If any one of the input is 1, you have a 1 as output. When you negate that, you will get 0 as output. If any one of the input is 1, we will get 1 as output in the OR gate. Since we wanted to complement the result of OR, we will get 0 as output. And if all the inputs are 0, then we will get 1 as output. And this NOR gate is also a special function. We will see why later in this session. The input need not be limited to only 2 inputs. We can extend it to any number of inputs. In that case also, if all the inputs are zeros, we get a 1 as output. If any one of the input is 1, then the output of the NOR gate will be 0. The next is XOR gate. Symbolically, we represent XOR operation using a plus symbol enclosed in a circle. This is actually XOR because the expansion is exclusive OR operation. The Boolean expression is this one. The output Y is equal to A complement and B OR A B complement. This is the expression for the exclusive OR operation. So we have two inputs A and B. If we have A as 0 and B as 0, then when we substitute here, A complement will be 1 and B will be 0. So this term is going to be 0, and here A is 0, B complement is 1, and therefore the AND of 0 and 1 is 0. So both the inputs to the OR operation is 0. So the result is also 0. In this case, when A is 0 and B is 1, A complement will be 1, B is 1. So the AND of these two things will be 1 and 1 will be 1. Here it is A is 0, B complement is 0. So this term is going to be 0. But the OR operator is going to receive one input as 1, the other input as 0. So the result is going to be 1. In the third case, you need to just exchange the role of A and B because this is symmetric. This is A complement B. Here it is A B complement. So you need to just interchange the role of A and B to get this 1 as output. When you have both the inputs to be 1, A complement will be 0 and B is 1. So the result of AND of 0 and 1 is 0. Here A is 1, B complement is 0. Again AND of that will be 0. So both the inputs to OR operator is going to be 0, and therefore the output is 0. And symbolically you will represent the XOR as, we will have an extra curved line to the OR gate, that is the symbolic representation of the XOR gate. And here also the input need not be limited to 2, you can extend to any number of inputs. In that case, you first do the XOR operation between 2 inputs, and the result of this you XOR with the third variable and so on. That's how we evaluate the XOR operation. The next operation is the exclusive NOR operation. This is indicated by a dot enclosed in a circle. Actually, this XNOR is the complement of XOR gate. So that is why we have represented the graphical symbol like this. We have the XOR gate which is negated. The output of the XOR is negated to get the output of XNOR gate. And the Boolean expression is output Y is equal to A complement B complement or AB. That is the Boolean expression for the XNOR operation. So the truth table has two inputs A and B, and Y is the output. When you feed in 00 as input, A complement and B complement both are going to be 1 and 1. So when you feed in 1 and 1 to AND gate, the result is 1. And AB is going to be 0 because both the input to the AND gate is 0 here. So this term will be 1 and this term will be 0. And 1 or 0 is 1. And when you have any one of the input is 0 and the other input is 1, then when you have A complement, it will be 1, B complement will be 0, and vice versa in the third case. And this term again, A is 0, B is 1, again this term is 0, and vice versa in the third case. And OR operator is going to receive both the inputs to be 0, therefore the output of XNOR is 0. And when you have 1, 1 as input, A complement and B complement both will be 0, but AB will be 1. So this term is 0, this term is 1, so OR operation between 0 or 1 is 1. We get 1 as the output. This is XNOR operation. As I told you already, the NAND operator or the NAND gate is called universal gate because we are able to generate the fundamental operation, which is the complement, the AND operation and the OR operation, using the NAND gate, only using the NAND gate. Therefore, we can call this NAND gate as a universal gate, and that is why I said NAND gate is a special gate. Now how do we obtain the complement? So I just feed in the X, we use a complement gate here or the NOT gate here. Instead of NOT gate, you can use the NAND gate itself, but you have to feed in both X and Y as the same X, and we can get the output Y, but that is not necessary. This is a fundamental gate and this is easy for us to fabricate as well. And NAND operation, if we feed into the NAND gate, we get the XY, the whole bar. And if we complement it again, we get XY. So that is how we are able to generate the AND operation using the NAND gate. And for generating the OR operation, we negate X, so we get X bar here and X bar here. Similarly, we get Y bar here, and when we pass it here to the NAND gate, we get X bar, Y bar, the whole bar, which is actually equal to X or Y. We can establish this using the De Morgan's law. This is actually De Morgan's law. Later we will see this one actually, when we learn the Boolean algebra. Similarly, the NOR gate is also called the universal gate because the fundamental operations of the complement, OR operation and AND operation, we will be able to generate using only the NOR gate. And NAND gate and NOR gate are easy to fabricate. And in when we actually fabricate the circuit, we mostly use the NAND gate or NOR gate to develop the logical circuit. And here the complement, we use the NOT operator or the NOT gate. And for generating the OR operation, we feed in X and Y to the NOR gate. So what we get here is X OR Y, the whole complement. If we complement this once again, we'll get X OR Y. That is what is indicated here. The AND operation, we feed in X to the complement gate or the NOT gate, we get X bar here and we get Y bar here. And when we feed in X bar and Y bar to NOR gate, we get X complement or Y complement, the whole complement, which is XY. This is again the De Morgan's law, which we will see in the Boolean algebra. In the next video lecture, we will see the Boolean algebra and the relation between the Boolean algebra, why we need Boolean algebra to manipulate the Boolean logic expressions. Thank you for watching this video.